27 days to go to the megalithic election in the story of a country called Zimbabwe. Now, you can expect that every single day is going to produce some breathtaking drama. Let me bring you up to speed. Joyce Mujuru. Now, she's been pretty quiet since Tsvangirai was alive. 2 days ago, she gave an interview to Ruvheneko Parenyatwa where she said a whole lot of words, but she really said nothing at all. But I think there's something special about this lady and I want to help her. Now, she had a 45-minute interview where she was asked, how do you solve the cash crisis? Watch this.
What is your solution for the cash crisis?
Us as a PRC government, we are planning very hard that we have technocrats amongst ourselves, economists, bankers, those that have been involved in the outside world who have been doing a lot in this country. And we said we still have those connections amongst ourselves.
And then she was asked, what would she do to change the lives of young people? Watch this.
What is your plan to win the hearts and minds of young people?
Thank you very much. We have started implementing some of the issues that we are going to do when we are in government. Right now, you'll find we also have very youthful councillors. We also have very youthful members of parliament, my candidates. And the reason for doing that is we want them to see that they are welcome.
The rest of the interview, she waffled and gave Ruvheneko a history lesson about the really boring life that she leads. Joyce Mujuru has missed every opportunity to charm the voter. And clearly, she's not very good at interviews. She has a lot to say about the past especially, but Joyce Mujuru fails because she doesn't have much to say about the future. So here are four tips I want to give to presidential candidates before I help Joyce Mujuru of what you do when you go to an interview. Number one, always force the narrative. Number two, rebuttal everything with your narrative. Number three, if you don't know, just say you don't know. It's better to say you are still thinking than to give a stupid answer. Number four, discuss the questions before the interview and if they don't ask you the question that you want to be asked, just ask it for yourself. And I'm going to teach you how you do that. As for Joyce, the next time, Joyce, if they ask you, Joyce, how do you solve the cash crisis? You say, you can't solve the cash crisis. Because no one man can solve the cash crisis. Solving the cash crisis will require a full team effort. It needs a whole team complement to be able to do this. In fact, it's the one issue that is actually going to unite this country. You see, Zimbabwe differs on many things, but we all want money because money buys nice things. So everybody will have a role to play. The investor has to bring in the forex. Yes, government needs to make it attractive for that forex to land by removing stupid restrictions that is in the way of capital. For example, the stupid visa regime, the taxes that are too high and too many. Government has to get out of the way of capital. The citizenry needs to roll up its sleeves and get to work. But before we roll up our sleeves and get to work, we have to commit to understanding we need to be trained better and educated better in the skills that actually matter and move us to a new economy. You know that a country is growing by the amount of cement that's being sold, by the amount of bread that's being sold. So we need to know how to use our hands to build. And we need to build better and we need to build faster. We need to learn how to operate robots instead of knowing how to operate with a class 4. The entrepreneur needs to know how to answer one important question. What needs to get done? Because where there is a problem, therein lies the solution. And where there is a solution, that's how you get paid. If the problem is there's not enough housing, you have to reimagine how we build cheaper houses and build them faster. That's how we mark competitiveness. When you say cash crisis, you're simply saying there's not enough money that is going around for everybody to be able to touch it. If you want more money, you're going to have to create more activity. The money will come. Don't worry about it. Worry about what it's coming to do. But more than that, worry about what are you doing that you are going to get paid to do. Stop focusing on what's happening with the voter's role. Worry about what's happening with the gold, the chrome, the platinum, the lithium, before it even leaves the community you live in. If you're asked, what are you going to do to change the lives of young people, Maya Mujuru, this is how you answer. You say, three things. One, you're going to ensure that they are properly skilled to compete in a new age economy. And these skills are in agriculture, mining, chemistry, robotics, science and technology, but most importantly, leadership. Number two, you're going to say you will mainstream the agenda of youth empowerment from top down, beginning with appointing a special youth advisor in the president's office. And that allows you to create a direct channel or communication line between the president and the most important group of ideas that is in the country. The young people in this country, they're like, they're all chunked into one big pot and they are boiling with ideas. Currently, that pot is lid-locked with a mercury lid and it's waiting to explode. Then you say number three, you will force alternative financial inclusion. There are too many good ideas and innovations in Zimbabwe, but there is simply not enough funding to support the ideas that the young people of this country have, so they get tired of aspiring. Now, the strategic angle you must always play, Mujuru, is you are the unifier. You're weak everywhere else, you know that. I mean, you're actually useless everywhere else. But ask yourself a question if they don't ask you. You are a unifying president. You want to be president because you want to focus on building and not destroying. You want to be president because your strength is your strong maternal instinct. You've understood your whole life the importance of building consensus. You did a great job managing men who used to work above you. You did a great job managing men at your level, managing men who were working under you in an environment where women were told they cannot enter politics. You broke that glass ceiling. You were the one who made men salute women when men had dared never to salute women. You beat men because you worked harder than them. Sell that. You're a widow. You've had to raise kids. You've had to be a professional woman. You've had to go through a divorce. You're not a smart lady, and that's okay. Because you were busy fighting a liberation struggle when your friends were in school. Chamisa can never be the unifying factor in the country. The boy can't even unite his own party. You took everybody that ZANU-PF was spitting out, that MDC was spitting out. You can challenge ED. And you can say, well, ED is not a unifier because instead of building a GNU, he decided to take it to the elections. You are the only one who can weaken ED because right now, 27 days to go, ED, Emmerson Mnangagwa, is an unstoppable train. Until tomorrow, head bowed. Hi guys, thank you for supporting the Lumumba Files. To make sure you don't miss the show, press the subscribe button below and the notification button, that's the one with the little bell, and you will always get told when I put up a show. Thank you for watching, head bowed.